building a TNR is not very difficult. It's just like, you know, you should know how to approach a faculty and like, you know, how you convert your, you know, networking with that faculty into an RA or TA. So what I would suggest is that for a research assistantship position, you would like want to take a subject under the faculty, and then, you know, you perform well in that subject, and like, you know, midway through your semester, or maybe at the end of the semester, you approach that faculty for an RA position. So if there is if there are any RA positions available under that faculty, which you would obviously know by that time, you would just have to sit and crack the interview. But let's say if you're someone who's not in contact with the faculty, and then you want to apply for an RA position under that faculty, it would be difficult for you. It's not impossible, but it's just not easy for you to get an RA position under a faculty with who doesn't know you well. As far as like the TA goes, I think you would already know that my ASU portal has this job section, you know, on the webpage itself. So, you know, you would find faculties and, you know, not just faculties, all the other part-time jobs as well being listed on that portal. So you would just sit and apply for TA positions. And, you know, if possible, let's say if you're in contact with a faculty, like right now, before going there, I would suggest that you ask them or approach them like before going to the US. But if you're not in contact with any faculty and you just like apply for a TA position on the job portal, it's going to be difficult for you to get an RTA or an RA like from back here. For an RA, I would say that, you know, there's just less than 10% of students who do get an RA. As far as TA goes, most of the students don't apply for a TA once they get a part-time, because TA positions are not easy to manage, because a friend of mine who's a TA, usually, you know, he has to sit like almost he might have to pull an all-nighter right before his exam doing his job, which would be to grade other papers. So most of the students, not most, I would say a few, like more than half of the students avoid, you know, a TA position. But if you want to get a TA position, it will not be that hard. You just need to speak to the faculty or the subject in which you are good. Let's say you're good at technical drawing applications, or you're good at a business subject. Then you approach a faculty who is teaching that subject and tell them that you're interested in, you know, a position, a TA position if there are any. And then, you know, they might get back to you stating, you know, what are the next steps that you need to take in order to, you know, schedule an interview, or maybe, you know, they might ask you for your resume, or they just recognize your profile as a whole. As far as RA goes, I believe you can pay around $1,600. But, you know, it actually depends on, like, what faculty are you on. I think it's somewhere around $1,200 to $1,600 per month, which is more than enough to cover your living expenses. As far as TA goes, I believe you earn around $1,000 to $1,200 in your TA position, because you get paid around $13, I believe, per hour, and you're not allowed to work for more than 20 hours. Part-time jobs would usually pay you somewhere from like $10 to $13 an hour, depending on what kind of part-time job you get. So let's say if you get a part-time job, it should be enough for you to cover all your living expenses. You know, like everything, including, you know, your books and your utilities, your transportation. Thinking about getting a part-time job is that, you know, when you're applying for a part-time job, they will ask you for reference. So even if you don't know a posting, you would have, or even if you have no references, you won't be able to proceed. You need to have at least 3 references, or I believe 2 references, to, you know, even make an application. So if you want like any references, you can use your, you know, you can use your classmates or even It's pretty easy. I believe ASU did have like a statistic on their web page which said that, you know, 2 out of 3 students looking for a part-time job to get in. Despite ASU like being, you know, the largest public school, and you are, you know, it's not that hard to get a part-time job. You should get a part-time job, provided that, you know, you have proper references and you apply. To break down the cost, I would say, you know, your master's degree, like per subject, is $3,900. That would be around $39,000 to $40,000, just for your courses. But you know, generally speaking, a semester wise, I would say, you know, my fees would be around $14,000, which includes, you know, my health insurance, my GPSA fees, the SDFC fees, tuition fees, the healthcare facility fees. Everything would be under like $14,000.